And welcome to Let's Play Wiz and Liz. I'm Duke of the Bump, and when we last left off, I was on a shopping spree. Let's see. I forget what I was about to do. What do I have? Oh yeah, cabbage. Well, let's see. I guess I could buy something random to go with the cabbage. Yeah, let's do that. That leaves me with 71. I was hoping to play, well, that was a lemon. I guess I could play Take a Chance again, just to give me, some more time. Screw it. I'll do it next time. If I die, I die. I know you guys want to see more than just that one game. Now, this is probably the first game I ever played with, an abundance of mini-games. No invisible letters. That's what I was talking about earlier. When you get an invisible letter, it makes you lose one. Which I wasn't really at that point anyway. But yeah. This is the first game I've ever played where there were a lot of mini-games. I figure I should probably at least show off one of the hints, just to give you a general idea of what they do. Don't forget that the A button drops you through a platform. Actually, that's helpful, because I do tend to forget that from time to time. There are some hints that, if I remember correctly, aren't really that helpful at all. Like, there's one that says, A to drop through a platform. There's one that says, if you go to put in a password in this game, and you put in BBBBBB, nothing but B's, do I only have one door left? Cool. If you put in nothing but B's, it brings up a password, or a hint, that says you're gonna have to try harder than that. You know, guessing passwords. So, hopefully in this video, I should be able to show off the first boss, which I don't really remember who the first boss is on Wizard. I think I may know, but... Uh-oh. I need to stop ending sentences with "but." It's a really bad habit of mine. It's like I'm about to say something else. There it is. But then I end up just not saying anything else, so... I just kind of trail off. Hey, bonus letter. Grab that. So I've come dangerously close to dying, like, way too many times for being this early in the game. Kind of embarrassing. After I beat the first boss, the levels will repeat again. And I think they'll be... Yeah, they'll be different. And then once the levels repeat, they get a little bit harder each time. Like, bigger... more exploding wabbits, more invisible letters. And then there's another boss. And I think there are three bosses on Wizard. Or maybe there's four. It's been a while, guys. You'll have to forgive me. Bonus letter? Alright. I think we have a boss coming up. Get ready. Prepare to meet your maker. Snake Eyes. Oh yeah. I guess the freaky flower only shows up on Apprentice. So, here comes the violence. Which is really pretty tame. When you get right down to it. I mean, you're firing glitter at a snake. Ow. And avoiding its tail. And when you get hit, you make a squeaky sound and you flash. So, it's not really very high on the gore factor here. I mean, this isn't exactly Splatterhouse for playing. Thank God. Not that I have anything wrong, or not that I'm opposed to Splatterhouse. It's just not my... Oh! Crap. I just blew that snake's eye out. Apparently, your magic power in this game is a Red Ryder BB gun. Or the equivalent. It's waning wabbits! Move along, little doggies. Move along. Congratulations! You have defeated Snake Eyes! With only 2 units of health to spare. So it does a score countdown for the whole game, for the whole world so far, which we don't have to watch. Hey, I got an extra life. Alright, well, that was impressive. Let's see what we have. Mango and an orange. That sounds pretty tasty. So, let's see. 10 seconds extra time. That sucks. See how the password up there changed when that happened? The password actually reflects how much time you have, which is kind of cool. Okay, well, I only have 80 stars. Oh, the fruit's more expensive every time too, which is kind of a bummer. 450 stars for an extra life. That's ridiculous. Why would you do that when you can buy a mushroom and an avocado for only 390 stars and that gives you an extra life? I don't get it. Maybe they're hoping you don't know that spell combination. It's a secret to everybody. Alright, mine land first. It's tradition. So, I'm taking a break from Bayonetta at the moment. That's the game I've been playing the shit out of lately. It's awesome. By the way, I got an Xbox 360, if any of you out there want to add me. My gamer tag is Duke of the Bump, which shouldn't be surprising. But yeah, I beat Bayonetta on normal, then I went back and beat it on very easy so I could get the an item that helps me cheat. Well, not really. And now I'm trying to play through on hard, and that's another reason I wanted a nice, easy, relaxing game like Wiz and Liz. Oh yeah, there are 3 stages now instead of just 2. Crazy! Oh yeah, this game is just a stroll through the park, let me tell you. Not stressful at all. Uh-oh. I think I'm dead. Crap, 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 crap. Ugh! I just missed it. Damn. Well, there goes my first life. And it starts you back with nothing, of course. But it puts a minute 30 seconds on the timer, which is nice. That's the reason I don't really like timed games. They're so damn stressful. Like when you're playing Sonic and you're about to drown, and it starts playing that really sinister countdown music. Ugh. Gets my heart racing every time. You notice that it starts out a little easier, actually, when this, I mean, I guess it's like a stage or something. I don't know. But it starts out, there aren't as many wabbits to collect, and not as many, well, that's pretty much it. Alright, what do we have? An orange, a potato, and an apple. Well, it sounds kind of nasty, but let's make some orange potato soup. We'll pretend it's a pumpkin. That's less nasty. Well, I guess eating a pumpkin would be kind of nasty, but not, oh, wow. The classic cell phone game, finally available on your Genesis home video computer entertainment console. But yeah, like I was saying, pumpkins are pretty nasty. I mean, I like pumpkin pie, but I don't think I'd eat anything else made out of pumpkin. But you have to admit, it goes better with a potato than an apple does. So, this is thrilling. 10 points, wow. That's a lot of points. 10,000? That's even more. I'm not sure what's up with the cactus border. It has like weird cactus faces. And it's against a background of a starry night. So yeah, there's not much to commentate on here, is there? Eventually, I'm going to get so long that I can't avoid running into myself, and the game will be over. No, you don't get anything for accumulating a certain amount of points, or at least I never have. Or surviving a certain amount of time. All you get are points. I'm probably stupid to try to go for that, but hopefully that part of my tail will be gone by then. Oh shit! Oh, it's on now. What am I going to do? Oh, snap, check it out. I've got some Elite Snake skills going on. This thing looks like it's made out of Lego. It does look more like a centipede than a snake, though. It looks like it has, like, pincers on its head. Oh, I think this is the end. Oh, good timing, because you know what that sound means. Game over. This has been Dookie the Bump. I'll see you next time on Let's Play Wiz and Liz.